Hey, this is Ben, and I teach you how to write Unity shaders from scratch. Today's video, I've been requested by a couple of people to do some sort of night vision effect. So this will be the effect that we're going to do today. This is what it looks like without any lights. So we do have a post effect running right now. It's just a simple screen tint. As you can see, it's going to pass zero. So it's going through here. And if we go to our camera, we have a very light screen tint. Cool. So let's create our night vision. So the first thing we want to do is get the luminosity of the color of the screen. So luminosity is very simple. It's just float. It's equal to, let's call it luminosity. It's luminance. Unity has a shader function for this. Luminance, and all you do is pass in the RGB of the color. And let's display that. Cool, so the next thing we want to do is have this luminance have more contrast. This is not the best contrast function, but it's a very simple one. We simply do a lerp. We lerp by a midpoint. 0.5 might be a bit too high actually right now because 0.5 is so dark. And we need to have it lerp it by a contrast amount. So maybe let's just say 5. If I save that off, it'll probably turn black. But if we lower our midpoint, say 0.1, we'll start to see our objects back. So let's also saturate this. It'll help us with the math later on. Cool, so we need a couple of values. So we have a screen tint. We're gonna keep that. That's gonna be our night vision tint. So what we'll need is a contrast multiplier and maybe a midpoint. So let's go with luminosity midpoint. Next, we need a luminosity intensity. We're going to remove this ripple intensity. We don't need it right now. Next, we need to make sure these are applied in the shader. So luminosity MP and luminosity intensity. Our MP is going to replace the 0.1, and our intensity is going to replace this, the 5 here. Okay, now we should be able to lower this. Maybe 0.4, and maybe have this one to be set to maybe 10. So once you have your luminosity, you just simply want to multiply this against our screen tint. And then take our color and return it here. So what we want to do in this case is we want to multiply it by green that is kind of have a little bit of red, a little bit of blue, and a little bit more green. And the reason why we want to do this is because when we multiply a value like that, what will happen is it'll start off going to green first. And then as it gets hotter and hotter, it will go towards white. So let's do one more multiplier value. We'll call it night vision intensity. Go ahead and put that in here as well. Let's go ahead and ramp this up to maybe about 10. So right now it's color times equals. It should just be colors equals. We don't want any of the original color in here. There we go. That's the issue I was facing before. And that should be kind of it on how to kind of get a simple version of kind of a night vision type of an effect going. You can also change the different type of colors, maybe make it grayscale. Maybe if you do a grayscale, this is a bit too high. You know, have some fun with this, play around with this one a bit. It's also based on the lighting. So, you know, of course, if your lighting is too high, it would affect it. But if there was no lighting, it would be dark like this, right? So yeah, that's it for me in this particular video. If you guys like what you see, please subscribe and support my channel, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye now.